I've got Alastair Ford with me this morning from Mining Capital. Alastair, morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Certainly been an interesting week. We've had the US pull out of the Iran nuclear deal this week, Alastair. Moving commodity prices a tad. You've been monitoring the situation. What's your view?
Well, yeah, it's been an interesting week in terms of global politics with the withdrawal against the advice of its allies at the US from the Iran deal. So quite a lot of uncertainty around what's going to happen next. And that's been visible, as you suggest, most clearly in the prices of two particular commodities, the gold price and the oil price. Now, the oil price is an interesting one because obviously it's volatile anyway in terms of what the US does in the Middle East, but particularly with respect to Iran, which is one of the region's largest producer. And Iran supplies a lot of oil to countries like China and Japan. And those countries will be now subject to US sanctions. So a certain amount of uncertainty in the oil industry about where the supply shortfall will be made up, or whether there'll just be sanctions busting on behalf of some of the countries like China. Japan's expected to comply, but China more of a wild card, as we know, and relations with the USA blow hot and cold, depending on the moods of the various leaders and other factors. So the oil price moving on that. With gold, initially there wasn't much of a movement in gold because the US dollar is strong anyway. Contrary to the FX markets in the first few months of the year, the US dollar has recovered its ground. It's now trading quite well. So tough for gold to make traction or get any traction in a market with a strong US dollar. As we know, they're quite inversely correlated. But even so, after a sort of sluggish initial response to the withdrawal of the US from the Iran nuclear deal, gold price then did tick up by about $20 or so. So I think we're seeing some safe haven buying from investors. Certainly in the UK, interestingly, we're seeing a spike in the purchase of gold. Some commentators suggesting that with property prices on the decline, actually the appeal of gold as a safe haven for UK investors is increasing as their other options decrease. So much demand in the UK, around the world, some significant demand. I think we'll have to see what happens next, really. The Israelis bombing the Iranian positions in Syria the other day, that looks like it might be a prelude to an escalation in violence in the Syrian war and in the conflict between Israel and Iran. But it's possible that the Iranians might wait for the Europeans to make an offer, or at least to see if they can salvage the deal before they start really stepping up hostilities. So it's a bit of a wait and see situation as far as the gold price is concerned. But if hostilities do escalate, as they may well do now, then I think gold will go higher.
I think on the subject of gold, it's been quite an intriguing few weeks for Chaarat Gold and their attempt to acquire the Kumtor mine from Centerra Gold in Kyrgyzstan. Slightly unusual situation here, Al.
Yeah, it's a power play of a different kind that we've got going on here. The Chaarat team, completely revamped board at the top of Chaarat. After several years running Chaarat, Dekel Golan now stepped aside, the long-standing founder of Chaarat. And there's some serious financiers now running Chaarat. Martin Anson, the major shareholder, is very well connected at the top of capital markets. And the deal maker there, Artem, is also very well connected and used to work for one of the major Russian mining companies. So he knows what he's doing. And then financial level, there's Pete Gardner, highly rated in the city, formerly with Amara Mining, which sold out to Perseus a couple of years ago. And there's also Dusty Nickel, who we know from Azaga Mining, which has Russian assets. He's the head of exploration at Chaarat. So it's a highly rated team, a highly competent team, and they've put together a offer for the Kumtor mine, currently owned by Centerra, completely unsolicited. But intriguingly, it looks like they stand a good chance of getting the backing of the Kyrgyz government, and it may well be that the Kyrgyz government has a significant say in who actually ends up owning the Kumtor mine. So even though Centerra may not be a willing seller, it may find that it's been given an offer it can't refuse, so to speak. The offer seems to be a reasonable valuation in terms of the figures that Centerra's put out. itself as far as what the mine's worth and its production. It's a very good mine, well-known mine in Central Asia. And what's actually perhaps more interesting from the Chaarat point of view is that the Chaarat team are saying this is actually just the first of many deals that they intend to do. They intend to invest upwards of $600 million in Kyrgyzstan, not counting this particular deal. And that's something that the Kyrgyz government will find very attractive. So many interesting angles to this deal. It's a bit of a game of poker going on. Centerra not saying anything at the moment, but they've been given this attractive offer, and the Kyrgyz government are going to debate the offer in Parliament. So it's going to be high profile as far as the country itself is concerned. And it will be interesting to see what happens to Chaarat and to Centerra from here on in. The Chaarat share is currently suspended, of course, whilst this is ongoing, because it will be a completely transformative deal. They've also got a smaller, I should say, gold project in Kyrgyzstan, which they're working towards production. But the acquisition of Kumtor would really catapult it into the big leagues of gold miners.
Certainly will be interesting to see how it all plays out. Another company with an exposure to gold, albeit on a slightly lesser extent, Anglo Pacific. We're expecting their quarterlies in the next week or so. What will you be looking out for?
Well, the gold that Anglo Pacific has been very steady for them. The El Valle Carles mine in Spain, a good project. They acquired their royalty on that some years ago when it was still in development. And since then, it's been paying them nice dues. Anglo Pacific, as we know, leveraged significantly towards coal. Coal has been doing well in the markets, and contrary to a lot of publicity in the Western world and the European press, is still very much in demand. So I think we'll see a steady set of numbers from Anglo Pacific. What really will be interesting for the company in the weeks and months ahead will be to see what sort of deals they are able to put together to acquire further royalties, because Julian Treger is on record more than once as saying he'd like to do more deals this year. He'd like to do three or four, he's told me in the past. So somewhere along the line, I think they're going to start announcing deals, and what shape or form those take will be a matter of some significant interest.
Just a quick word from you, Alistair, before you go. I'm catching up in the studio a bit later on. Harry Adams from KEFI, all eyes, as far as they're concerned, on moving towards construction, getting things going at Tulu Kapi in Ethiopia by the end of the year.
Yeah, it's been a long road for Tulu Kapi. KEFI have brought it along quite successfully after it was completely hidebound in, under its previous owner. So they did have to do quite a lot of fixing and mending fences over in on the ground at Tulu Kapi. Now they're beginning to get the financing package in place. The bond financing has been mandated. And I think that at last we'll begin to see some serious work happening on the ground at the project itself. It's an interesting project. There's lots of gold there. At one point it was very much out in the wilderness, but over the years, they've built up the infrastructure around it. It's relatively easy to access. I think the mining costs will be attractive, and there ought to be some pretty good margins there. So the key moment will be when this financing properly closes, and we can watch the company begin to get on and build a mine, which is what it's been hoping and wanting to do for a few years.
That's great, Alistair. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.